Hello everyone, welcome to the GU Ecologist. I am Dr. Krishnanand and you have been watching my series on oceanography. So in this session on oceanography, we are going to learn about the ocean bottom topography of Pacific Ocean. So remember, in the last session, we already learned about the ocean bottom topography of Atlantic Ocean. So let's discuss about the Pacific Ocean in today's session. But before we go ahead, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and do share the videos with others as well.
So after we have learned already about the basics of oceanography in the first lecture and also about the bottom relief or the ocean bottom topography of Atlantic in the last lecture, now it's time to learn about the Pacific Ocean, its ocean bottom topography. So the first thing, that is, where does this word Pacific come from? So what happened? The ocean's current name, that is Pacific Ocean, was coined by a Portuguese explorer, Ferdinand Magellan. Remember the age of discovery? So during that time, the Spanish circumnavigation of the world in 1521, it was happening. And during the circumnavigation of the world, he encountered favorable winds on reaching this particular ocean. So this ocean was where this wind was blowing in a very calm manner. So that's where he called it Mar Pacifico, which basically means, both in Portuguese and Spanish, peaceful sea. So Pacific basically is the word for peaceful. That's important to remember. Now, looking into the configuration and size, Pacific Ocean is the largest and deepest of the world oceans that we already know. Right, it's about 60.06 million square miles, or about 155.557 million square kilometers in aerial coverage of the Earth, and it stretches from Arctic Ocean in the north to the Southern Ocean in the south. Now remember, we have already learned about Arctic, Antarctic and the divisions and the other portions. So remember, right from the Arctic, it extends to the Southern Ocean. So this entire stretch that you see in this particular, this is what is the entire Pacific Ocean, right? So it also sits between what you see, Asia. So this is where you have Asia, right? Australia. So this is where you have Australia, as well as the Asia and North America, and Australia and South America. So what you see here is Asia and North America, right? This stretch, and Australia and South America. So what we observe is the boundaries are covered by Asia, Australia, North America and South America largely. And in the down south, you have Antarctica. So this is how it is bounded from all sides. And that's important to remember. Now let's learn furthermore about Pacific Ocean. So looking at the average depth value, first of all, it is about 7,300 meters. So remember, it is one of the deepest oceans that we already know. And its shape is roughly triangular with its apex in the northern Bering Strait. Remember, this is a Bering Sea and this is Bering Strait. So what you find, this is like a triangle structure, right? So this portion is like an edge of the triangle, and nearly about 20,000 islands dot this vast ocean. So remember, this vast ocean is dotted by about 20,000 islands. So this is the huge number that we see. So Pacific Ocean largely covers about 28% of the Earth's surface. And remember, in the World Factbook of CIA, it's also said that it's almost equal to total land area of the world. So remember, this total oceanic area is equal to the total land area of all the continents of the world, roughly about same. So that is an approximation. So Pacific Ocean is usually divided into North and South Pacific regions. Now remember, this is your northern part and this is the southern part, right? So Northern Pacific Basin and Southern Pacific Basin are two segments divided by roughly this equator. So this is to remember that there is a division between North and South on a bigger scale, on a macro scale. And further, there are more regional divisions as well. So what are the regional divisions? If you see, North and Central Pacific, this is one regional division. So this is Northwest Pacific. Remember, this is one important point. Then this is the central portion, right? And then you have Northeast Pacific. And then further, you have Southeast Pacific. Remember, so accordingly, you have different regions in the Pacific. It's so huge that several regions have been identified. So North and Central Pacific are characterized by maximum depth. Now remember, which is the maximum deep area? It is North and Central Pacific area. And some well-known trenches like Aleutian and Kuril Trench. Now remember, these are the two names and we are going to learn about separately as well. So these are the famous trenches that are located here, apart from the famous Mariana Trench that we already know. So there are also large number of seamounts and giots that are present, right? So in this particular zone, you have large amount of sea mounts and gyres as well. Now, if you look into the west and southwest Pacific, the average depth is about 4,000 meters here, right? So that's important. And it is marked by a variety of islands, marginal seas, continental shelves, submarine trenches. So this is important to remember. And that is where in the western part, that is where this portion comes. And that is where Mariana Trench is located. And apart from that, also Mindanao Trench are located. So this is about 11,000 or 10,000 meters deep in the range. So what you see is that some of the deeps, the greatest deeps are located here, right? And some of the major trenches are located in this belt. So this is the entire location of these trenches. And now come to the Southeast Pacific, right? So Southeast Pacific is this particular region adjoining South America. This part is conspicuous for absence of marginal seas. Now remember, here there are no marginal seas if you observe, right? That's important to know. And the Tonga and Atacama trenches are prominent in this particular zone. So let's understand further more on these trenches, on these ocean features. So if you look into this image, now it's very clear here, we have already learned about all these trenches which are there on this entire ring of fire diagram. So this is what you see as the ring of fire, or the Pacific ring of fire we see. And remember, we have learned about the Aleutian Trench, Kuril Trench, Japanese Trench, then what we have is the Philippine Trench, and this is where you have Marianas, right? In the west part, and in the Middle American Trench region, you have Peru-Chile Trench, and then just opposite what you have is the Tonga Trench, right? So these are the major trenches that we already have learned. Now, why are these trenches formed? So to understand why this is entirely a ring of fire belt produced, on what basis, how it is formed, it is important to understand and revisit again the theory of plate tectonics. So remember, plates moved, they came together, they again moved. So this process was happening continuously. We have already learned in the continental drift and plate tectonics theories. So what happened? The formation part, if we see, the formation of Pacific Ocean was about 250 million years ago, right? And the breakup of Pangaea is one important thing. That's why we say that about 300 million years ago, when Pangaea started to break up, many oceans were formed. So what was the primitive ocean then? It was called Penthalassa Ocean. And from Penthalassa Ocean, different landmasses separated, and in between different oceans formed. So one of them is Pacific that we see, right? So there are no specific date or when the Pacific Ocean developed, but this is only because the ocean floor is constantly recycling. Now remember, subduction process is happening. So this plate, if you see, is moving like this, and this is moving like this, and this is subducting under this one, right? So Pacific plate is subducting under the Eurasian plate. And that's why lots of changes are happening on these boundaries. So what you see is that during this subduction process, the material which is melted into the Earth's mantle, it goes, and again it forms ridges when it comes up. So what happens, you see, this entire zone is full of all volcanoes, right? Because subduction happens. And remember what we learned in the plate tectonics, that when one plate subducts and it again forms the magma and comes out from the different areas. So that's where ocean ridges are found. So currently the oldest known Pacific Ocean seafloor, remember ocean floor, this floor portion is supposed to be 180 million years old. So remember, from 250 it started to form, and 180 is the current situation. It basically means what? That newer crust has been constantly forming, right? So that's why the entire ocean floor dates to about roughly 180 million years old. So in terms of its geology, the area encompassing Pacific Ocean is sometimes also called Pacific Ring of Fire. This we already know. And remember, this is the world's largest area of volcanism and earthquakes that we already study under volcanism as well as under earthquake process. And also remember, it is one of the areas which clearly tells us about this theory of plate tectonics, and it's currently visible and it is evident by looking at this particular subduction zones and also this ring of fire, volcanism, and several volcanic hotspots as well. So now let's elaborate further more. So now looking at the ocean bottom topography, remember, the Pacific Ocean or Pacific Basin may be conveniently divided into three major physiographic regions. One is the eastern, the other is western, then you have central. So remember, eastern, then you have western, and then you have central. This is how we divide, and this is how the Pacific Ocean from British Columbia in the east to the Japan in the west looks like. Now, can you see here the oceanic crust, right? It has been exaggerated a little to just highlight what are the features. So you see continental slopes, then you have seamounts, a basal plain, this huge flat area, then some emperor seamounts, huge seamounts, right? Then some smaller seamounts, then you have trenches on this particular coast, which is the Japanese coast side. Remember the Marianas and the other trenches. So what we observe is that the main features of the Pacific Ocean floor are what? The continental slopes, which drop from about 200 meters to several thousand meters over a distance of just few hundred kilometers. So very sharp decline, that is one thing. Right, the abyssal plains, so exceedingly flat, the central area is exceedingly flat area, which is one of the deepest areas of the world, right, in terms of ocean floor. So that is 4000 meters to 6000 meters deep, and volcanic seamounts and islands, trenches at subduction zones that are almost 11000 meters deep. So this is what you see in this portion, the trenches, and these are the seamounts at certain places. So this is what entire ocean bottom topography looks like. Now let's elaborate one by one further more. So looking into the eastern region now. So which is the eastern part? This is the eastern region, right? So eastern region or eastern Pacific region, which extends southward from Alaska to Tierra del Fuego and is relatively narrow and is associated with American Cordilleran system of almost unbroken mountain chains. So what do you observe on the eastern side is right from Alaska, this entire zone, right? This is what you observe is in the eastern portion, right? The mountain chain running parallelly to the ocean. Right, so continental shelf, which runs parallel to it, is narrower on the eastern side. That's to remember that eastern side, the shelf area is little, right? And remember, the slope area is very steep. That's important to remember here. And significant ocean trenches in this region are Middle American Trench in the North Pacific. So this is about Middle American Trench, and then what we have is the Peru-Chile Trench. So if you look, this portion has a trench, and then you have a Peru-Chile Trench here. So that's important to remember. And Peru-Chile Trench is in the south, and here you have is the Middle American Trench. So that is what you observe in the Eastern Pacific region as a bottom topography. Then come to the western part. So this is what you see is the western part, right? And what we observe is this seaward boundary of the Western Pacific region is marked with broken line of oceanic trenches. So you see several trenches, right, in different parts. So this is a broken line of several trenches: Aleutian Trench, Kuril, Japanese Trench, Tonga, then you have Kermadec trenches and several other trenches that are named here. And you can see the entire region is full of trenches, right, from Aleutian to Tonga. So this entire area is full of trenches on the western margin, and its structure is more complex than that of the eastern. So eastern is less complex, but western, what you see is the more complex region, right? So it is more active region as well. Subduction zone is more active here. So characteristically associated with ocean trenches. And remember, there are several islands and peninsula as well located in this particular belt, which is tectonically very active. So island clusters of Western Pacific form the boundaries of several wide and deep continental seas of the region as well. So which we are going to learn as the basins. Now let's look into the central region. And the central Pacific region lies between the boundaries of the eastern and western. So remember, this is western, this is eastern. So where is central? This portion is the central portion. So when you see the central portion, what is the major feature here? The largest and the most geological stable of the structural provinces of the earth. This area is one of the most stable zones. Remember, this is most active zones. These are the most active zones. So in between this particular area, the central portion is one of the most stable. If you say stable, basically what? Geologically stable or tectonically stable, that is what it means. So it is characterized by expansive areas of low relief, it's just flat bottom, and general depth of about 15,000 feet, that is averages 4,600 meters deep about this central Pacific region. That's important to remember. Now going to the deepest trench, the very famous, the Marianas, remember? It is how much? It is 35,840 feet deep, roughly 10,924 meters, which is estimated about 11,000 meters deep. Remember that? So the Pacific is home to the deepest ocean point in the world, which is called Challenger Deep in the Mariana Trench. So this is that particular area. You see this Western Pacific area where you have Mariana Trench and Challenger Deep. So this is to be remembered on map as well. The topography of the Pacific Ocean varies even more drastically near land masses and islands. So remember, these are the land masses and island areas if you see. This is where it drastically varies. It basically means there is a huge diversity of these physical characteristic or physical features, right? So some coastlines along Pacific are rugged and have high cliffs and nearby mountain ranges. So remember this entire mountain range along it, right? Such as west coast of United States. So this is where you have entire rugged topography found. Other coastlines have more gradual, gentle sloping coastline. So the other side has gradual or gently sloping coastlines. Some areas such as coast of Chile have deep, quickly dropping trenches near the coast. So this is where you have Peru-Chile Trench and it's huge or which is very deep trench, right? So that is important. While others are very gradual. So there are many island chains and small islands like those in Micronesia and Marshall Islands. So where do you locate these Marshall Islands and Micronesia? This is the area. You have numerous islands in this particular belt, right? That is called Micronesia, right? So that is important to remember. And largest island in Pacific is the island of New Guinea. So you can look into this particular image. Where is New Guinea? This is the largest island. Right, so this is important to remember in terms of the island distribution and variety of features or kind of geodiversity which is there part of the Pacific Ocean. And finally, one very interesting point which is called Point Nemo. So if you have watched that movie Finding Nemo based on Jules Verne's 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, it's the same Point Nemo which is kind of an unknown place or one of the remotest areas on the globe. So it is about 2980 miles from New Zealand, and then 1666 miles from Deuce Island. From Easter Island, it's again 1666. From Chile, it is 2624 meters. So remember, from all these mainland, this point is the farthest point, right? So officially, it is also called Ocean Point of Inaccessibility. And why it is in news? Because it is kind of a graveyard for the space junkies. Remember, that's important. Why? Because 250 to about 300 spacecraft, which have mostly burned up, have been put here and laid to rest. So basically what it is also called a graveyard for these spacecrafts or space debris. So that is important to remember. And remember, the other name for this Point Nemo is the Oceanic Pole of Inaccessibility, which was officially discovered in 1992 by survey engineer Voye Lukatela. So this is important to remember that this is the farthest point on Earth and also called the graveyard for the spacecrafts or for the space debris. That's important to remember in terms of very specific feature of the Southern Pacific Ocean.
So now, when we have learnt in details the ocean bottom topography and all other features related to Pacific Ocean, in the sessions to come, we'll be talking more on oceanography of Indian Ocean. So stay tuned, stay safe, all the best.